Ministry of Finance Bill, Parliament Suit Africa, Ms. Kume. I'm here for Kenya, I'm here for my people, I'm here for your rights.
You're being treated as prisoners. They're trying to fight for you.
Kenya has been rocked by widespread demonstrations against the recently proposed finance bill, leading to violent clashes between protesters and the police forces. The bill, which includes increased taxes, has faced significant opposition from citizens who argue that it will exacerbate economic hardship. In the heart of Kenya, a powerful movement is rising, Generation Z. The youth of the nation has taken to the streets in unprecedented numbers, voicing their fierce opposition to the controversial finance bill. They argue that these measures will only deepen economic struggles and limit opportunities for their future. From Nairobi to Mombasa to Kisii to Kisumu and many other counties in Kenya, the message is clear. The youth are demanding a seat at the table, rejecting the policies they believe are out of touch with their realities. The protesters escalated dramatically on the 25th of June, culminating in thousands of demonstrators, which they stormed and even burnt Parliament. As you can see, even in this video, there's this guy who entered Parliament and started filming himself inside the...
I'm here to address you. You must go. Ruto must go. Kwapa. Not when...
Reverend Dennis Ntabo Basweti.
After the chaotic day that protesters stormed the parliament and burned part of it and other government buildings, the demonstrators vowed to escalate their actions and storm the state house on the 28th to actually meet with the president. The mounting pressure and growing unrest led to President William Ruto to address the nation. In his address, President Ruto announced the withdrawal of the controversial finance bill, aiming to restore calm and engage in dialogue with the nation's youth.
Loudly, that they want nothing to do with this finance bill 2024. I concede, and therefore, I will not sign.
Following President William Ruto's announcement to withdraw the controversial finance bill, the unrest in Kenya shows no signs of abating. The youth who have been at the forefront of the protesters remain unsatisfied and are now calling for President Ruto's resignation. As the bill is pulled back, the nation watches closely, hoping for a peaceful resolution and a better future for all Kenyans. As Kenya navigates this period of unrest, the focus remains on whether the government can rebuild trust and meet the demands of its youthful population, or if the calls for change will lead to further political upheaval. The demonstrations have not been without conflict. Clashes between protesters and police have turned violent, with reports of injuries and tragically loss of life. The youth of Kenya are calling for change, but their cries have been met with force. It was crazy, guys, in Nairobi. The chaos led to extensive, you know, property damage. Others were looting on the shops. They even burned some part of the parliament building, and even City Hall was burned, and other even, not only in Nairobi, also in other counties like Uasin Gishu, they burnt the governor's office. It was crazy in Nairobi.
Sawa, sawa.
The protesters have seen a heavy police presence with several clashes reported between security forces and demonstrators. Tear gas and water cannons have been used in attempt to disperse the crowds, leading to injuries and further escalating tensions, which Kenyans actually do not care. They continue to fight for their rights. President Ruto's recent announcement to withdraw the bill, the protests have continued unabated. Demonstrators are now expressing deep distrust in the current administrations and are united under a new rallying cry, Ruto must go. And the wave of protests against the Kenya controversial finance bill has not only gripped the nation but has also sparked solidarity demonstrations by Kenyans abroad in cities like United Kingdom, Washington, D.C. in the USA and also Los Angeles. Kenya patriots have taken to the streets rejecting the finance bill and calling for President William Ruto's resignation.
And we are in solidarity with our brothers and sisters in Kenya.
Despite the government efforts to restore order, Kenyans actually came out on the 28th of June. The demands for President Ruto's resignation have grown louder. The protesters are calling for a complete overhaul of the political leadership, citing corruption, economic mismanagement, and lack of accountability as key issues. As Kenya faces this critical juncture, the future remains uncertain. The ongoing protests highlight the deep-seated frustrations of the populace and the urgent need for political and economic reforms. The coming days will be crucial in determining whether the government can regain the trust of its citizens or if the nation will continue to be gripped by instability and calls for change. And it's me, Agizuena, your host. Thank you for watching. Subscribe and like, share and comment below.